40 years of asbestos lawsuits have bankrupted almost 100 companies, costing tens of thousands of jobs. It's the longest-running mass tort in history. Former Washington State Attorney General Rob McKenna says Congress created trust funds to help asbestos victims.
Bankruptcy trust funds were set up to create a smoother, frankly, less burdensome process for people who became sick from asbestos and deserve to be compensated from the companies that exposed them to asbestos, companies that went into bankruptcy under a special provision of the federal code.
The trusts once had $30 billion, but that is fast dwindling. The recent Garlock bankruptcy shows why. Here, two claims were filed with separate trusts, but for the same person. The first says the victim was exposed to asbestos at an Illinois power plant. The second alleges exposure at a steelworks in Alabama during the same time. The Wall Street Journal documented claim filings for individuals who don't exist. These schemes make millions for some lawyers, but drain the money pool for true victims. The Furthering Asbestos Claims Transparency Act, or FACT Act, deters fraud by making public some trust claims data. Plaintiffs' lawyers say this harms victims' privacy, a charge McKenna denies.
There are no privacy risks from the provisions of the FACT Act and the information that it will require be made available to the bankruptcy trust judges and to the parties in those bankruptcy cases. For example, the proposed bill explicitly protects confidential medical information, prohibits full Social Security numbers from being released, and so forth.
Less information than even lawsuits publicly disclose, says McKenna. Until Congress acts, unscrupulous lawyers will continue to game the system at the expense of real victims. For more ridiculous lawsuits, go to facesoflawsuitabuse.org.